I yawned and stretched out my back. There was something very homely about Monk Park Hall, alone here in the dark. Obviously, the place was familiar from the smell of the woven grass matting, which made the corridors smell like a haystack, the slight hum of the security lighting that illuminated small patches of each room, and the odd, slight draft that brushed my cheek. I was as accustomed to being in here as I was to being in the cottage, really, with the hours I'd spent hanging around waiting for Mum and then Gran to finish work. I wandered down from the old kitchen, running my hand along the panelling, feeling the change of grain where some of the old panels had had to be replaced 15 years ago. The worn patch and the matting was still there in the doorway, where underneath the stone flagstones dipped, scoured away by generations of feet passing through. My feet felt it, but my mind hardly registered, although it did tell me where I was. I could have walked this house blindfolded and still known from the smell of the air, from the feel of the walls and the way the floor lay, where I was. History sat heavily in the air with the dust as I wandered through into the library. How many people had polished in here over the years? How many maids had rushed through, using the library as a shortcut to the yard, probably against all the rules? I stood in the middle of the dark room and breathed the smell of old books, floor polish, and the faint odour of potpourri from the little bowls scattered around, which made the place smell vaguely of cat wee. The merest suggestion of a draught ruffled the hair on the back of my neck and made the skin down my arms prickle, as though a ghost stood just behind me. Not enough to make me turn around, but enough to keep me moving forward, tracking the origin. I'd been right. The draft seemed to originate from one of the almost invisible cracks that marked the position of the priest hole. I held my hands out in front of me and waved them about, trying to locate the exact position. I must have looked like some sort of Harry Potter of the hardback, wafting my arms up and down, as though I was trying to conjure the books into life, but eventually finding the point at which the cooler air was making its way in. A tiny hole, which looked as though a mouse had chewed through some of the panelling, was letting the slightest trickle of air through.